areas of management, governance, and leadership. Trained in medicine, he has worked for 15 years in the healthcare and pharma industries before focusing on his passion full-time. He has authored 30 books and 600 columns, including bestsellers such as My Gita, Jaya, Sita, Business Sutra, and the Seven Secrets series. Pattanaik's TV shows include Business Sutra on CNBC TV 18 and Devlok on Epic TV. His most recent books are Leader, Insights from Indian Mythology, Culture, 50 Insights from Mythology, and My Hanuman Chalisa. Before we begin the session, I have one small request to all members of the audience. Devdutt will be available for signing and interaction after the session is over at the bookstore. So if you want to interact with Devdutt, kindly make sure he can go to the bookstore as soon as possible. You can create a line there and you can interact with him there. If you help us and cooperate and make the entire process smooth for us, it's going to be a better experience for you at the end of the day. That being said, let us welcome Devdutt with a huge round of applause.
You know, Malvika has indulged me. I have a problem speaking in the main... she loves that venue. She doesn't like this venue. And I like places which other people don't like. No, basically, you know, this is closed space. And I feel jab hum kahani bata rahe hain, when we are telling stories, you need a sense of intimacy. And when it is an open space, वो इंटिमेसी नहीं रहता है मुझे तकलीफ होती है बोलने में इफ देर आर थिंग्स फ्लाइंग अराउंड बर्ड्स एंड एनिमल्स एंड पॉलिटिशियंस इट्स एक्सट्रीमली डिस्टर्बिंग सो तो आज सो आई बी टॉकिंग रियली अबाउट दर्शन एंड इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ माई राइटिंग तो आई बी टेलिंग अ लॉट ऑफ स्टोरीज सो बेसिकली स्टोरी टेलिंग सेशन इट्स द एंड ऑफ द डे सो जस्ट एंजॉय योर सेल्फ ज्यादा सोचिए मत एंजॉय द स्टोरीज But I want to begin in a very unusual way. You know, there was a book a long time ago I read. Or didn't read, I saw it in a bookshelf. And you must have known the book. It's a very famous book. It's called The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. And when I saw that book, I smiled. I said, an American has written this book. Because if he's a monk, he will not sell his Ferrari. He'll give his Ferrari away. There will not be his Ferrari because once you become a monk, you own nothing. You cannot have his Ferrari. So what title jab maine dekha, I found it to use this very big word nowadays, problematic. It was problematic because And it is a best-selling book on spirituality. But title mein hi mujhe gadbad dikha. I said, American hi hoga. Of course, later I figured out it is American. But the thing is, why am I saying this? Is because for me, this was a moment of darshan. Shabd ke piche bhav kya hai? Behind words, there is an emotion. When you use the word monk, you have to immediately understand what a monk means. And the moment you know what a monk means, the choice of verbs, the choice of possessive pronouns instantly get impacted. Agar bhavarth ko samajh mein aate hai, if you get the meaning of the word, you will not use the word sell his Ferrari. Shabd. Otherwise, you look at monk as someone who wears saffron robes. To bhavarth jab samajh mein nahi aayega, to aap shabdarth mein atak jate ho. You get trapped in the literal. And when you get trapped in the literal, you have goons pretending to be yogis. भाषा और अर्थ शब्द और अर्थ लैंग्वेज वर्ड एंड मीनिंग वर्ड हैज फॉर्म सगुण होता है साकार होता है अर्थ जो होता है वो निर्गुण होता है निराकार होता है लेकिन सगुण अगर नहीं अगर शब्द नहीं होगा हाउ विल यू कम्युनिकेट मीनिंग जब तक शब्द आपके पास नहीं है आप meaning, earth ko vyakt nahi kar paoge. You can't communicate. How do I tell you a thought? Shabd mere liye ek patra hai. Shabd is a vessel through which meaning is being transmitted. Shabd is a mean, is a vessel containing meaning. Shabd ke piche arth hota hai. Sagun ke bhitar nirgun hota hai. Jab tak sagun patra nahi hoga, nirgun arth nahi milega. You won't understand the meaning. So in order to understand the meaningless, the meaningful, formless world, you need form. You need akar. You need shape. You need words. The ability to look at the meaning beyond the word is called darshan. Isko darshan kehte hain. Jiske paas aankhe hain, jiske paas kaan hain, wo shabd sun lega, shabd dekh lega. Lekin jo darshan karta hai, wo shabd ke piche arth dekhta hai. He is able to get it. And this is the struggle of a writer. The struggle of a writer, he is not communicating words, he is communicating meaning. He transmits meaning using words. To ek bhav, jab log kehte hain ki vedon mein gyan baitha hua hai, that knowledge, that meaning, in order to communicate, I need words. Mujhe shabdavali chahiye, I need vocabulary. Mujhe vyakaran chahiye, I need grammar. I need intonation. Mujhe chand chahiye. Because the same word has different meaning depending on how you say it. I can say stupid. I can say stupid. It has a very different meaning. Tum bahut mahan ho can be said cynically. Tum mahan ho can be said with reverence. To ek bhav vyakt karne ke liye mujhe shabd chahiye, vyakaran chahiye, chhand chahiye. So much I need to communicate a idea. So when you read the akhyans, when you're reading the stories, I keep telling people ki wo bhav dekho, shabd mein mat atko. Because once you don't get the idea, you will never get it. You will still say monk selling Ferraris. Because you are fascinated by Ferrari. You want to own the Ferrari. And you believe value in selling and buying. Tumhe monk, bairagi ka arth samaj mein nahi aaya. Bhikkhu ka matlab samaj mein nahi aaya. So you go on and on giving lectures, but you until you get it. Ki uska arth kya hai? Aap apne aap ko guru, sadguru, shri shri kuch bhi bol sakte ho. ज्ञान जब तक नहीं आएगा उसके लिए कॉस्ट्यूम की आवश्यकता नहीं है. हम कॉस्ट्यूम की दुनिया में हैं जहां पे शुभ्र कपड़े पहन के बाय वेयरिंग क्लीन क्लोथ्स वी बिलीव वी एग्जिबिट अ क्लीन कैरेक्टर. क्लीन क्लोथ्स आर क्रिएटेड बाय वॉशिंग पाउडर निर्मा. Orange clothes don't mean you're a yogi. Big beards refer to Dumbledore, not to Gurujis. Digambar ka matlab ye nahi ki tum nange ghumo. Because if you want to see nude people, you can go to any nude beach. Kapde utarne se aap digambar nahi bante. Digambar ka arth samjho. Digambar means a meaning which is shown of words. Nirgun jise sagun ka aadhar nahi chahiye. These are the ideas that our ancestors are trying to communicate with us. For thousands of years they have used different technologies to communicate ideas, concepts, ved, vichar. What I'll do today is just use this one idea of darshan and show how the eye is used to explain concepts. You know, the best visualization for me, for Indian philosophy, or more than Indian philosophy, I would say the method by which India communicates is the wheel, जो चक्र होता है हमारे flag के बीच में. Nowadays the flag has become very important for all strange reasons. But we don't, we are looking at the orange, we are looking at the white, we are looking at the red. We are not looking at the wheel. हमारा दर्शन, क्योंकि हम रिलीजन को देख रहे हैं ना, भाव को नहीं देख रहे हैं. भाव उस चक्र के अंदर है. बिकॉज द चक्र इज द सिंबल ऑफ बुद्धिज्म, जैनिज्म, हिंदुइज्म. इट इज लार्जर, इट इज सनातन. इट इज ट्राइंग टू कम्युनिकेट दैट द मीनिंग इज द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल. द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल इज द मीनिंग. इट कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन डिफरेंट वेज. So each way is a ray. It's that spoke which is moving away from it, which creates a wheel. So infinite possibilities exist to explain the same concept. उस एक भाव को व्यक्त करने के लिए हमारे पास अनंत शब्द हैं. That is why every time I write a book, I say, within infinite myths lies an eternal truth. Who sees it all? Varuna has but 1,000 eyes, Indra 100, you and I only 2. That is the coming from the wheel. Kitum anant, the entire circumference. In order to show the circumference, I can do infinite variations exist to communicate the same idea. One of these spokes is the eye, the eyes. Through the eye. So when you go into a temple in India, the most important ritual is called Chokhudan, where you give eyes to the deity. So in Calcutta, when the Durga Puja is held, the statue is Nirjeeva. It has no value until the ritual of Chokhudan. Because when that ritual is done, it is called Prana Pratishtha. After that moment, it stops being a statue. It becomes a living, breathing entity who gets up in the morning, eats food, takes a siesta, talks to you, watches performances, listens to your petitions, engages in dialogue with you, and at the end of the day has her meal and goes to sleep. To wake up again in the morning, it is no longer a statue. It becomes a swaroop. भगवान का वो स्वरूप बनते हैं. फॉर दोज फ्यू डेज इट इज अलाइव. नाउ यू विल से, बट इट इज नॉट अलाइव. इट इज सेइंग डिवेलप द एबिलिटी इन योर हेड टू ट्रांसफॉर्म द स्टैच्यू इनटू अ लिविंग थिंग. तुम्हारे में वो प्राण शक्ति है कि शब्द के अंदर तुम अर्थ ढूंढ के उसे जीवित कर सकते हो. जैसे शब्द के भीतर अर्थ डाल के उस पर प्राण डाला जाता है, वैसे ही मूर्ति को आप जीवित करते हो कुछ दिनों के लिए. और तुम्हें बताया जाता है कि एक दिन, वन डे, दिस स्टैच्यू हैज टू डाई. बिकॉज जस्ट एज वर्ड्स जॉइन मीनिंग्स, वन डे दे विल सेपरेट. सो देयर इज आवाहन एंड देयर इज विसर्जन. एट दैट टाइम इट इज जस्ट अ स्टैच्यू. People say, अरे दुर्गा पैसे को फेंक दिया पानी के अंदर, with so much of disrespect, because it is just a statue made of clay. Only when it is in the mandap between the avahan ritual and the visarjan is it alive. It's a goddess. Before that, it is a dead body. After that, it is a dead ajeev or nirjeev. It is without life. Words are like that. Words acquire meaning and they disappear. They come and they go. Words come and go. Words come and go. This is what is communicated. And therefore the eye is given a lot of importance. Dekho. All of us have been given eyes. Do we see? How many of us feel invisible? Koi mujhe samajhta nahi hai. Nobody understands me. I hear children say that. I say husbands say that. Wives say that. Sons, daughters, lovers. Parents, powerful people, the rich man sits with his wealth and says, "Koi mujhe samajhta nahi hai." We just had a session of 3 women who feel misunderstood, and people around them feeling they don't see how much we love them. This loneliness This loneliness, ki koi mera darshan nahi karta. Dekhte hain mujhe. Dekhte hain mujhe. Lekin darshan nahi karta. Kyunki when you swipe your card, the computer knows you exist in office. But your boss doesn't see you. That is the feeling of existence. Today you are alive when a computer system says you are alive. This is the world we have come down to. You are dead only when you are registered. You are alive only when you are registered. Hum darshan karna bhool gaye. Jab tak aadhar card nahi hai, aap manushya nahi ho. It shows the stripping away of humanity. We don't see each other. We go on a date with a beautiful boy or a beautiful girl and we spend all our time on WhatsApp. And you feel invisible. I am not there. Nobody sees me. The child is seen because it is crying and crying and crying. Once it starts, it learns to shut up. You stop looking at it. Duryodhan spends his entire life not being seen. His father cannot see him. Duryodhan's father is Dhritarashtra. He is born blind. Wo dekh nahi sakta. His mother blindfolds herself for whatever reason. She refuses to see him. He is a child who has a father who cannot see him and a mother who will not see him. How is such a child to be? If you grew up never being seen by your father or your mother who are supposed to be the ones who protect you, do you think you will be a normal human being? Darshan karo Prabhu. So when Krishna looks at Duryodhan, what does he see? What do we see when we read a novel about Duryodhan? Because we are looking at him through the eyes of the novelist. What does Krishna see and what does the novelist see? Many fiction writers who write on mythology become judges and lawyers. The entire novel is saying he is good, he is bad. He is right, he is wrong. You take sides, you decide Karna is good, Karna is bad. Draupadi is good, Draupadi is bad. Pandavas are good, Pandavas are bad. Judgment. It is the lens of the fiction writer. Is that the lens of Krishna? How does Krishna see when he looks at Duryodhan? Remember, Krishna is filled with abundance. He has two fathers who adore him. Not one, two. Vasudev and Nand. He has two mothers who adore him. Yashoda and Devaki. They can't have their fill of him. He's surrounded by gopas and gopikas who adore him. He's surrounded with love. And then he goes and sees Duryodhan. And sees a poor man. Not the love of father, not the love of mother, no lovers to adore him. How will you deal with someone who has never been seen? Will you be kind and generous? Or will you be judgmental? You are wrong. You are evil. You are a monster. You should be disemboweled. Your head should be cut. Your bones should be broken. These are stories. This is how the Ramayana and Mahabharata, through just the eyes of the notion of the gaze, dekho. Bhagwan kaise dekhte hain? खुदान जब भगवान को दिया जाता है वो कैसे देखते हैं क्या आपके नजरिए से देखते हैं या वो 360 डिग्री व्यू होता है When I see the wheel In the center of the Indian flag, I see Jagannath's eyes. Because perhaps I'm Odia. Wherever you go, you see Jagannath. And you see, when you go to the Jagannath temple for the first time, or those who don't know Jagannath, it is very, I'll tell you something, I grew up in Bombay. I'm not grown up in Odisha. I'm more Maharashtrian than Odia, really, culturally. But Jagannath is the center of my life, and there's the image of Jagannath, and many of you all in Calcutta are familiar with the image of Jagannath. But please imagine, a friend of mine walks into the house, looks at it and says, Devdutt, what is Mickey Mouse doing here? And I'm appalled. I said, what do you mean, Mickey Mouse? That's Jagannath. He says, doesn't he look like, he's such an adorable Mickey Mouse. And I'm like, I hope he is destroyed right now. I wish Jagannath had a third eye. I am completely appalled until I realize he has never seen Jagannath. He has no exposure to Jagannath. Why should he respond to that image the way I do? I'm culturally immersed in that image. I've grown up with that image. I've been told repeatedly it's the most beautiful image on earth. Objectively speaking, I'm not so sure. But bhav alag hai na? Because there you have the Lord of the world, Jagannath, who has no hands, who has no feet, who has no ears, who has no eyelids, who has no... Standing there, smiling all the time, saying, don't worry, life is okay. And when you see that image, you're like, no, it's not okay. But you have an image of a round-eyed, wide-eyed deity saying, everything is wonderful. I have no hands, I have no legs, I have no ear. You have a deity who is incomplete, inadequate. You are told to worship perfection. Bhav of perfection, shabda of imperfection. The image is inadequate and it is used to communicate completeness. It is called Shunya Murti and Vishwarupa. It is zero and infinity, alpha and omega. But the form is incomplete. And you realize something is being communicated to you. This idea of seeing the world is so interesting. You see, there is this famous story in the Purans, and it became popular, unfortunately, because of our extremely literate government. Somebody decided that the festival called Onam in Kerala is Vaman Jayanti. And those who don't know, let me tell you the story. And the story goes that once upon a time, there was a king of the Asuras called Bali, Mahabali, who was generous to a fault. He would give you anything that you wanted. And the gods couldn't defeat him. The devas said he cannot be defeated because he is a king who makes everyone happy. Jo uske paas jata hai, usko sab mil jata hai. So he goes to his, so Indra looks at his younger brother, his Anuja, Vishnu, and says, do something. So Vishnu takes the form of a dwarf and approaches this man and says, I want 3 paces of land. And the simple version of the story is Bali gives it to him. And when Bali gives it to him, he becomes a giant. Vishnu becomes a giant and with 2 steps claims the 3 worlds and says, now I've covered the whole 3 worlds. Where do I put the 3rd step? And we are told that he finally puts the head on the head of Bali and Bali is pushed under the earth. And when you look at this story, this is a story. But there are little details in the story. The story goes that Bali has a Guruji called Shukracharya who looks and says, this little boy asking for 3 paces of land is a mischief maker. There is something happening over here. He tells Bali, listen to me, don't give him 3 paces of land. Bali says, no, I told I'll give whatever they want. I'll give 3 paces. Kya chhotu bachcha hai. 3 paces of land I will take him. If only he knew it was like Bitcoin. Just expand beyond imagination. He looked at him and said, I'll give it to him. And the process of giving it is to take water from land and to pour it and give it to him. He said, take swaha, swaha, swaha. And the pot, about to collect water, Shukracharya is determined to stop it. He becomes the little form. He becomes like a fly. He reduces his stride. He enters the pot and the snout, it is there. He goes and blocks it. He says, I will not let this transfer of deeds take place. If the water doesn't go out of the snout, Bali cannot give the land. Simple. So he becomes what most of our bureaucrats do. Wo file ghuma deta hai. But Vishnu, being Vishnu, says, oh, water is not coming out of the pot. Must some dirt must have gone in. He takes a little blade of grass. He shoves it in that snout. It's like a kettle pot. He puts it in the snout and he pierces the eye of Shukra. And Shukra loses one of his eyes, his left eye, and he comes out howling in pain. The water falls. The gift is given. Vishnu takes the three paces of land and conquers the three world. Which is why Vishnu is called Trivikrama. Now, depending on how you see the story has different meanings. So the right-wing version of the story is, and the conventional right-wing, let's not go into the depths of what is the meaning of right-wing, but what we know. The conventional right-wing version is, or let's call it the Hindutva version, Bali was a bad guy. And Vishnu, being Vishnu and therefore Brahmin, was a good guy. Good guy uses a clever trick to defeat bad guy. So being cunning or chant tha, dekha, usne defeat kar diya, villain ko maar dala. Because beyond that, intelligence hai nahi. So this is version one, but very popular version. It's simple, easy. Villain, hero. Hero uses clever trick to defeat villain. Wawa. Standing ovation amongst people with certain limited intelligence, which is okay. That version is allowed. It's, although I'm being very patronizing right now, but please remember, if you're telling the story to a child and the child says, mummy kya hua usko uncle ko kyu aisa kiya, cheating kiya na, what will you say? Nahi nahi, uncle acche aadmi nahi the, bahut chor the, wo itna log ko daan dharm kahan se karte, daan dharm kon karta hai, chori karta hai. Who does corporate social responsibility? Simple version. Bachcha. Samajh mein nahi aata hai. Tell him simple. Bali bad, Vishnu good. Because you want to convert him into the Vishnu worshipping, na? Bhadralok, Vaishnava, Gaudiya Vaishnava, all that chan, vegetarian. Bali was non-vegetarian, Vishnu was vegetarian. To save the poor animals from the planet. From this person who destroyed the climate by eating beef. Bas. Katam. Finished. Version 1. Version 2. Marxist version. Have to say it in Calcutta. I wish this was Cochin. And there it is. This was the happy land where there were no haves and have-nots. And an evil Brahmin comes and removes this land of equality and justice has been completely destroyed. But every year he comes back in Kerala for Onam. On Onam day, he returns to remind the public, the proletariat, that one day we shall be successful. Suddenly the have, the have not, and suddenly this new version is emerging. And you're listening, it sounds right, right? This little boy comes, this very mischievous, mean little thing. Three paces of land, but what he means by three is multiplied by n. And takes over the whole world. And look at this Darshan. Nice king, sabko, you know, gave subsidies to everyone. Believed in everybody should be educated, everybody, whatever you want, you can do. Good king, why do you have to remove him? Indra, Aryan, North Indian, Gangetic Plain. Hindi speaking person can't be trusted. In Bengal they say, na Hindustani. This is now becoming a racial conversation, a class-based conversation. It's very popular. This interpretation is very popular. Let's call it the left-wing interpretation. So you have a right-wing interpretation, Asura is evil, killed, blah, blah, blah. You have the left-wing interpretation, Asura is really the common tribal man who lived happily with nature until evil Brahmins from North India came and destroyed everything, which they always do. And then you're like, is that what the Vedas is all about? Is there another way of looking at the story? How do I look at the story? Kahani mein kuch to hoga, Shukracharya ka aankh phoda. Who is Shukracharya is the first question we have to ask. Shukracharya is associated with the planet Venus. He is considered, he is also called Bhrigu Rishi. There are two rishis who are very famous. One is called Angirasa, the other is called Bhrigu. Angirasa is associated with the Devas and Bhrigu is associated with the Asuras. And Asura live under the earth. And what exists below the earth? What exists below the earth? All the wealth in the world. Your crops, in order to germinate, have to go under the ground and then ankur, they germinate and come as harvest. All minerals under the ground. So primary wealth in its finest form, plant wealth, mineral wealth, water, everything comes from under the ground. So you have to pull it out of the ground in order to get wealth. So when they say asuras, they mean the creatures who live under the earth and have control to all the wealth, which is why Lakshmi is called Patala Nivasini. Lakshmi is called Patala Nivasini. She who lives under the ground. Trust me, when I said this in one lecture, somebody says, kya bol rahe ho, Lakshmi papi hai? And then I realized, little child. Because with a child, you can't give nuance. Mushkil hota hai. You have to move a little ahead. You know, you move from the right to the left and hopefully you go vertically somewhere else. And the conversation then becomes ki Patala Nivasini, she's under the earth. She is also called Paulomi, the daughter of Puloman, who is the king of the Asuras. She is also called Bhargavi, the daughter of Bhrigu, guru of the Asuras. Why is Lakshmi always associated with the Asuras? And of course, people will say, because wealth is evil. Because simple answer, na? Rich people have to be bad. Left-wing answer to everything. But when you go deeper, you realize it's saying that the wealth belongs under the earth until it is pulled up and taken from under the earth. It has no value. So Lakshmi has to go from under the earth, from Patala Nivasini, Asura Putri, she has to become Deva Patni. Only when she goes up, value is created. But what goes up comes down again because she will not last there forever. Lottery lagne ke baad bankruptcy aana hi hai. Paisa aata hai, jata hai, aata hai, jata hai. It's the cycle of life, which is exactly what happens to Bali. Whenever there is a harvest festival, he comes, after which he's forgotten. He goes, and again he comes, and again he goes, and again he goes. This is every year the harvest, every year the asura comes. He is killed. You enjoy the asura. And after that you starve and saying, I need the asura again. And then you dig for him under the earth. He comes back again. And again, and again, and again. It is the fertility cycle. Wealth keeps coming. It's your salary coming up every day in your bank account. On second, you go looking for asuras. Patal se nikla ki nahi. Because patal is what? Patal is your boss's wallet. And swarg is your wallet. When it moves from the boss's wallet to your wallet, you says, wah, wah, wah. And when the asura is generous, you love him the most. When the father gives you all the money you want, whenever you want, don't you like bosses like that? When was the last time you saw such a boss? Imagine your boss gave you whenever you want, whatever you want, which is what Bali was. He gave you whatever you wanted, whenever you wanted. And Vishnu says, that's a problem. We cannot let the boss give you your salary and bonus whenever you want, whatever you want, as per your wishes. Because resources are finite, but ambition is not. How do I tell this asura that he may say, I'll give you everything? But there isn't everything to give. Because when my ambition rises like a giant, he will have nothing to feed me. That is what Vamana is trying to communicate in the Trivikrama form. Human beings, do not ever think you can satisfy everyone's desire. Only a fool thinks like that. You need to be reminded that resources are finite and ambition is infinite. So if you tell the world, stay hungry, stay foolish, you will suffer from climate change. Because if everybody is hungry and everybody is foolish all the time, how much will you consume? How much will you consume? It will never end. Dete raho, dete raho, dete raho, dete raho. Bhook to lagti rahegi na. This is darshan. To be ability. When you see a rich man saying, I am ambitious. That's just a clever word for greed. Shabd ko kyu dekh rahe ho? Bhav ko dekho. Karodon ka dhan hoke bhi bolte ko nahi, next crore. Because next year also I want to be on the top Forbes list. And the list after that, and the list after that, I always want to be rich. Because it is never enough. Because I have been told, stay hungry, stay foolish till the day you die. To be content is contemptible in the new world order. To not have ambition, to say, chhod na. Aage bado ho gaya. Can you burp in satisfaction? Just eat, bas ho gaya, I'm okay. I have lived my life, I have earned enough, I'm okay. Why do we glamorize hungry people? Because none of the businessmen are working to satisfy other people's hunger. They are working to satisfy their own hunger. The politician is not out there satisfying your hunger. He is satisfying his hunger. Darshan karo. That is what Shukracharya is not seeing. Shukracharya is seeing, mera boss ka paisa koi chori karega. And Vishnu is telling Shukracharya, main uska udhar kar raha hoon. Uska dhan nahi le raha hoon, use gyan de raha hoon. Laaton ke bhoot baaton se nahi maante, mujhe laat dene do. Isle, if you see the image of Trivikrama, he's giving a laat, he's kicking him. And saying and pushing him under the ground and saying, don't be that arrogant. Stop. Calm down. The universe is infinite, but the resources you have are finite. Careful, careful, careful. You can't satisfy everyone's desire. Even God cannot satisfy everyone's desire. Mahabali kahan se aaya? Isliye naam diya gaya hai Bali. What is Bali? Sacrifice. Sacrifice. What is Mahabali? Sacrifice of your hunger. Not sacrifice of your food. Corporate social responsibility is not sharing a portion of your wealth. Corporate social responsibility is abjuring your greed. Chodo. I know I'm in Tata Lit Fest. But the shareholder demands you stay greedy. That's the problem. That is what darshan is all about. And therefore, Shiva has three eyes. With the third eye, he burns Kamadeva, Kamantaka. Destroy desire. So if Vishnu is piercing Shukracharya's eyes and saying, "Theek se dekh, do aankhe hai, lekin tu dekh nahi raha hai. You're not seeing. You are seeing wealth. You are not seeing hunger. Tu sagun ko dekh raha hai, nirgun ko nahi dekh raha hai." And Shiva is saying, destroy the hunger. And the goddess comes along and says, great. Destroying, you have destroyed your hunger. What about my hunger? You are the great Bairagi. You don't desire anything, but I am your Dharmapatni. I want something from you. And it's really a comment on Buddhism. Because Buddha has said desire is the cause of suffering. Whose desire? His desire, Yashodhara's desire, father's desire, son's desire, wife's desire, kingdom's desire. Because we all exist in an ecosystem of desires. Tum kiske liye jeete ho? The third eye of Shiva, which destroys Kamantaka, the goddess looks and says, तुमने तो जला दिया उसको, लेकिन भूख, भूतों की भूख कहां से मिटेगी? तुम अपना भूख मिटा दिए हो, लेकिन भूतों का भूख इज हंगर्स ऑफ द पास्ट. सो इट्स घोस्ट एज वेल एज पास्ट, ऑल योर पास्ट हंगर्स. यू नो, इन चाइल्डहुड यू डिडंट गेट द टॉय. You will always hear when people become very powerful, they'll say, you know, when I was a child, I did not get some toy and therefore I'm making zillions of dollars. I mean, I don't see the correlation between them. Or you'll read, authors will keep saying, you know, I was rejected 10,000 times and then I was published. And then, have you still not let go? Kitna pakad ke rakhoge, chodo. And so between the one eye and the three eyes, from one eye to two eye to three eye, it's the journey of giving up, recognizing hunger. Because hunger has no form. Food has form. When we say have and have not, famous theory, we are measuring hunger or food. And food you can regulate through policies. Can you regulate hunger through policies? निर्गुण को नहीं देखते हो, सगुण को देख के अटक गए. एन इकोनॉमिस्ट कैन ओनली मेजर द मेजरेबल ना. हंगर कांट बी मेजर्ड, ग्रीड कैनॉट बी मेजर्ड, डिजायर कैनॉट बी मेजर्ड, दैट इज निर्गुण. सो द जर्नी फ्रॉम वन आई टू टू आई टू थ्री आईज इज टू रेकग्नाइज द इनविजिबल हंगर्स in all our lives, not just our hunger, but the hunger of people around us. Not the hunger of Duryodhan, but also the hunger of Dhritarashtra and Gandhari. And what does someone like Krishna, who has seems to have access to everything, how does he engage with Duryodhan? Who is the have and who is the have not? Krishna, the cowherd, who seems to have nothing, and Duryodhan, who has the whole world. Who is the poor man in the table? Look at this conversation and ask yourself, who has one eye? Who has two eyes? Who has three eyes? Who sees whose hunger? Who cares about whose hunger? Who destroys whose hunger? And when you understand this, you will understand the Vedas. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Pattanaik, for that wonderful presentation. Members of the audience, I request you to remain seated. Members of the audience, I request you to remain seated. Let us please escort Devdutt out to the bookstore.
Questions?
Okay.
Three questions.
Yes, just three questions. And after that, if you could please remain seated till we escort Devdutt out. And you can meet him and interact with him at the bookstore, which is right outside the East Gate in Mohar Gunjo. Thank you.
You said mythology is about us, stories about human beings, human follies. So if we use Darshan to look at Vishnu, so he seems to be the judge everywhere, always doing the right thing. So what does that tell us? Like, we don't know if anyone...
Step one, he doesn't judge, which means you need to read more of my books. Only 299 rupees, available in the bookshop. Cannot answer this question till you have knowledge of my books, so please read my books and then we'll answer. Okay. Yeah? No questions after that? Because you know exactly the answer you're going to get? No, don't do that.
Hello?
Yeah.
You said that Lakshmi is Patal Kanya.
Yes, yeah? Patal Nivasini.
Nivasini. Isn't Shiva her father?
Not that I know of. But when I find out, I'll tell you. No, I don't know.
But...
I don't know.
Durga is her mother.
Abhi biology nahi establish hota hai mythology mein. You have an elephant. No wonder people believe elephant-headed god is plastic surgery. Literal nahi lete hain. Bhavarth, bhavarth. Yes, the gentleman there. That will be the last question and I'll leave, please. Thank you. Oh, there is a question here already. Sorry. That lady will get there.
Yeah. So, I just want to know, what's the source of your endless knowledge, your books, your knowledge, your everything?
Google.com.
No, Google doesn't provide that much knowledge about
the... No, it is not the library. It is the person who seeks the books.
it's not just about buying the books and reading them, I'm sorry. But it's
see, I gave you the answer which you're not willing to accept. Ab kya kare?
So you're saying it's just Google?
It is just, I was Googling right over there. If anybody had seen me over there, I was Googling. You'll be shocked at how much information there is. Just by giving Google mobile phones to people doesn't mean they'll become Devdutt Pattanaik. No? दान देने से लोगों की भूख नहीं मिटती. दिस इज द थिंग. वी अज्यूम बाय गिविंग एक्सेस टू फैसिलिटीज इट विल बी यूज्ड. यू कैन क्रिएट अ टॉयलेट, डजंट मीन आई विल गो टू शिट इन इट बिकॉज देयर इज नो वाटर इन द टॉयलेट एंड दैट इज अ बेटर रूम देन माय हाउस. आई एम मोस्ट प्रोबब्ली गोइंग टू स्लीप इन इट, बट दैट्स अ डिफरेंट कॉन्वर्सेशन. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.